Welcome to online classes, student. So let's start our new chapter, that is I share my world with them. Right? From whom we are sharing our world? From our pets, right? From the animals, plants which are around them, right? So in our previous chapter we learn about the plants, their leaves, their types, right? The uses of plant in our life, the importance of their plant of in our life, their leaves, how we uses their leaves in medicine, woods, you know, some color, eco-friendly colors. So let's start today about animals. They are around us as pet, as wild animals. They are living in forest, they are living in house, in our house. So today we are going to discuss about animals, right? So you can open your page number 65. On page number 65, the blue box, you can see there is a butterfly. Okay, on 65 page number. Now today is about what about animals around us, and then second one is about the movement in animals, right? As we are human being, we having movements, like we can move from one place to another as same as animal can do, right? A dog can move, they can they can run, they can walk, right? Just like us. So we can learn it about the how the animals are around us and how the animals movement, the movements in animals. And yes, about how the animals using their tails. Okay, so some other points we will discuss in other video, but let's start today chapter, today learning point, it animals around us. Okay, our world is inhabited by the numerous animals, birds. They can be found everywhere around our house, in the forest, the mountains, even underwater. From the huge blue whale to tiny organism like bacteria, animals are found in all shape and size. Just like a plant, in the plant, what we learn that the shapes, the texture, the color will be there is only difference in the color, texture and shape. But they are all our plants, just like in this book what they want to say, that yes, the animals from a big shark to a tiny organisms, like we can see the butterflies are very tiny, the worms are very tiny, but they all are come into the category of animals and insects, right? They are different, their shapes, but they are living beings, right? As human being, if we are living, we are moving, we are growing, right? We are in different in shapes, so they are also in different shapes, right? Different size, color. Each group of animal has certain features which make them different from each other, right? As you can see, someone is thin and someone is fat, someone is good, someone is little bad, someone is naughty, someone is very sincere. In human being, yes, this one is one of kind of features we have in our body, right? In our I have a different face, you have a different face, you have a different feature, you have a different voice, right? I have a different voice, I have different ears, I have different lips. So you can see we having a different difference between each another. So you can simply see this kind of feature in animals also. They having the different feature each from the each another, right? So we have done about the around us animals, that we know about the animals having the same features like a human being. They are also living, and the how they are different, their sizes different, their shapes, right? But they are living beings and they are same in category, right? So let's start the movement. As you can see, we having legs, right? We having our feet, we having our by legs we can run, dance, anything what we want to do. And in the movement in animals, we are going to learn that how the animals are moving, right? Their movements. So you can see most animals move on four legs, right? You can see some animals are moving on four legs. For example, giraffe and rhinoceros, right? So some animals like cats, dogs, lions have padded feet. Padded means these called paw, right? Paw. You can see they having a if they will hold a position, they can tight over it, right? They never slip over it because they can, a better placement. They can take their power into the grassroots level. So that is their, feature of that particular animal. They allow them to move silently. By this feature, they can move silently. You can see, if you have ever seen the Geographic channels, the lion, when they go to, forest to hunt any animal, they always use their paw to move silently. And what they do, they hunt the animals, right? By their slow movement. This is one of the feature of their, animal. Of lions, giraffe, you can see. Okay. Cats, dogs, lions. Now, horses, cow, camel move with the help of hooves. So you can see the examples are given to you. You can see this one is hooves and this one is paw, right? Whenever you see a dog, you can see their legs like this. A cat, a lion. And when you come to a point, horses, they having their legs like this. Okay. So by the paw they don't making noise, but with the hoofs they making noise with it, right? They having a great noise of it. You can see the horses when they run or they walk, the hoofs make noise, right? So horses, cows and camels move with the help of hoofs. Birds have 2 feet. Now as we learn about animal, now we having about the, birds, how they do. They having 2 legs, right? Their wings help them to fly. Snakes lie on ground. You can see birds have 2 feet, but they having wings, they can fly, right? All birds, all insect having a particular thing which make them different from other one. If snake having the feature of they always just slide on the grounds. And yes, centipedes and the caterpillars have many feet and they help them to move. These are small animals and they are very thin, but they having so many legs. That's why they are different from others. You can see the caterpillars, right? Now, as we learn how they move, right? The paw, which ones they have paw, right? They move very silently, and those who having hooves, they make noise when they run, when they walk, and like bird, they having 2 feet, but they fly with their wings, right? And yes, some other snakes they don't have legs, but they can slide over the ground. And the second, the caterpillars. They are small animals, but creatures, but they having so many legs, okay, so make them different from others. And yes, you can see how they move by feet, they move by their wings. Yes, and how do animals use their tails? As we learn about the animals around us, now we are going to learn about the movement in animals. Now there is a point, how do animals use their tails, right? As we having brain, we have kidney, we have lungs, we have 5 sense organs. So similar that animals having so many different things from just like us. Yes. So one of them is that how they are using their tails. Okay. If you remember in our previous chapters, right? In our previous chapters, we learn about that how dog show their emotion by their using their tail, right? So monkeys swings from one tree to another using their tails. So the tail of animals serves special purpose. They are using their tail for the special purpose. You can see monkeys swing from one tree to another using their tail. As we can say in the pictures also, they are using their tails to take as a swing, to make swing on trees, right? They are using it. So you can see the monkeys using their tails, and some special purpose for swings, and their tails help them to balance their body also. So this is one of the special part of their body of monkeys, right? And when we come to birds and fish, use their tails. They having tails also. We can see the fish having shape like this, right? In the last, they having tail. And when they move into the water, that that gave them a direction, right? They use their tails to move in a particular direction. If they wanted to go in the north side, they will take their help of, you know, their tail, and they move to that direction, particular direction. So you can see dogs show their affection by waving their tails. As I said, they wave their tail to show their affection and emotions. So you can see dogs also having their tail to show their emotions, as we have our face to show our emotion. You can see if I'm smiling, that means I'm happy, and when I'm sad, that make me sad. I will be like this, right? A simple face, a fat face, will be know that it's a sad face. And yes, when I will be angry one, that look different, right? And yes, so cats show their anger by raising their tails. And how the cats show their anger? By raising their tails. Okay, so different kinds of things you can see, that how the animals showing their, you know, feelings by their tails. And yes, there is a quick question also, how do sharks navigate using their tails? Find out. So student, this is for you. You have to find out why the shark use their, you know, what they do with their tails. So please find out. This is your term. You have to find it. And yes, now come to the point of animals as friend. You know that animals are friend. That's why they are our pets now. Some people think that the dogs are very loyal. That's why they make them as pet. Some people love the cat innocence. That's why they take as, you know, cat as their pet. And yes, some of them take rabbit, pigeon. So many, animals used to be kept in their houses as their pet. So we must always treat animals with love and affection. That is must. Why? If we have feeling about that something is right, that is love. You know that you love your parents. Parents love you. That's why they care for you. As is saying, when we love someone, we care for them. Our affection towards them. So we should know that how to care and how to treat the animals. So we should know how to treat the animals, right? We must not tease them. We must provide them enough food, take them to, you know, veterinarian. If they fall sick, as we go to doctor, they go to veterinarian, right? So how we have to learn that, how we can preserve them in a good manner, being a good friend of them. When we have a good friendship with them, that's make us a good human being. Because they don't have special feature like us. They can't speak, they can't show their emotion by, they can't having words. They can show only by some reaction. We can see they having, they showing their affection toward us, right? So students, you can see, as we learn about animals, birds, let's see some birds' affection, right? Birds are also part of ecosystem. We all know that the birds are the part of ecosystem. We can see in the sky that the place, their home of, you can see the home of birds is sky, right? There are different kinds of birds in different parts of the world. They have colorful feathers and different types of beaks and claws, and some of them may have melodious voices as bulbul, right? Koyal. So these kind of birds having their melodious voices, some having better voices like crow, and yes, some of them they can't fly, but they known as bird. Some can fly high. They having some strong, you know, strong, we can say, essence in the features. Birds are also part of ecosystem. There are different kinds of bird in different parts of world, and they have a melodious voice, which we have learned from the 67 page number. So you can see here in the left side, in the right side, quick question. Can birds fly backwards? If yes, name them. Hummingbirds, right? Hummingbirds can fly backwards. They are known for their this feature. So you can write here hummingbirds. Food for birds. Birds have different eating habits. So student, food for birds we will do tomorrow. Okay, this is for our tomorrow chapter, tomorrow. Okay, take a, you know, date over it so we can write it. Today's date is 28, let's do this, 28 July 2020, right? So always take your pencil to write anything over the book. Thank you students, take care, safe at your home, bye bye.